So good morning each one of you. Children, in today's class we'll continue chapter number 10, respiration. So already we have learnt types of respiration, human respiratory system, how they breathe. Now today's topic is how animals breathe. Different animals we are able to see in our surroundings. So there is a different way of breathing in the animals. So let's discuss one by one. Few of the animals like elephant is there. Elephant, lions, cows, goat, frog, lizard, snake, birds, they all have lungs. So you may underline, they all have lungs in their chest cavity like the human beings. So these all animals breathe through the lungs. So what about the other animals? Let's talk about cockroach. Cockroach has a small opening on the sides of the body, and these openings are known as spiracles. So children, cockroaches breathe through these tiny openings, which are known as spiracles. Okay. And insects also have a network of air tubes called the trachea for the gas exchange. Same thing is here, oxygen rich air rushes through the spiracles and diffused in the tissues and reaches to the each and every part of the cell. And carbon dioxide that comes out of it. So in the same way, in here you have to learn that cockroaches breathe through the small openings called spiracles. This question may be in 1 mark or maybe in 2 mark. If this question will be in 1 mark, then you can write maybe this MCQs form. Maybe aa sakta hai aapko ye question, or if the explanation will there, then you have to write 4-5 lines about it. Next is earthworm. Let's discuss about earthworm. Each one of you have seen earthworm. Earthworm breathe through their skin, and the skin of earthworm is moist and slimy on touching. Again, the exchange of gases takes place through the skin. Now let's take an example of frog. You know, frog is an amphibian. Amphibian means it lives on the land as well as in the water. So it can breathe through both the ways. If it is on the land, it will breathe through the lungs. And if it will be in the water, it will breathe through the moist skin. Okay. Next comes fishes. How fishes breathe? I think it's very, very clear to you that fishes breathe through the gills. Gills help them to use oxygen dissolved in water. Okay. And yes, gills are well supplied with the blood vessels. Here the exchange of gases takes place. Children, up to here, am I clear? That what are the different organs for different animals to breathe in? Is that clear, or should you need any of the repetition? Okay, fine. Let's move now. It is a turn of plants. Children, on the board you can see that I had written the different organs of breathing. How different organs breathe? See, cockroach breathe through. Tell me, spiracles. How cockroach breathes?
Spiracles.
Earthworm through the
moist skin.
Fish through the
gills.
And frog through
skin, lungs.
Frog is amphibian. Okay, it breathes through both. Now it is a turn of plants. Let's discuss how plants breathe now. Children, can you tell me which gas plants breathe in?
Carbon dioxide.
Wait, children, hold here only. Plants breathe oxygen and give out carbon dioxide as we people do. That you are saying for the photosynthesis. Plants use carbon dioxide for photosynthesis, and that is different from respiration. Photosynthesis is the process of preparing food. Am I clear? For the process of photosynthesis, plants use carbon dioxide. And for respiration, plants use oxygen. Okay? Like other living cells of the plant, root cell also need oxygen to generate energy. Roots take up air from the air spaces present in the soil particles. So we can say that roots also breathe. They take air from the root spaces which are present in the soil particles. So you can see in figure 10.11 how root here are helping the root to take the air. So this is a soil particle. Root go inside and take the air from it. Next comes, so this is the last part of the chapter. One question is here. Can you guess what would happen if a potted plant is overwatered? I think each one of you are having the plants at your home in the pot. So what will happen if you will be overwatered? Aap usko pura bhar dete hain upar tak. Then what will happen? Do the roots able to breathe? Do the roots will be able to breathe?
No, ma'am.
No, because there will be a water logging. There will be a water logging. The roots will not able to breathe. Children, you can frame one extra question over here. Kindly frame one extra question. The same question is there. What would happen? Yes, the same. What would happen if a potted plant is overwatered?
So there will be no space left for the root cells to breathe.
Yes, that's why. So with this, your chapter is over, children. Let's discuss a back exercise. Very less questions are there. Why does an athlete breathe faster and deeper? Divyanshi, please don't write. Deeper as usual. Children, kindly give me the answer.
Ma'am, can I tell?
Beta, aap aise nahi bologe. Kindly raise your hands, each one of you. Okay, first of all, let's recap what we have did today. So children, I hope this concept is totally clear, that how plants, different plants breathe. So let's see. Cockroaches breathe through spiracles. Earthworm breathe through. How they breathe?
Through moist skin.
So there is a reason, because earthworms are made up of muscles only. They don't have the bones. That's why they breathe through the skin only. Moist skin. Slimy or moist skin is there. Next, fishes. Fish breathe through.
Ma'am, gills.
Gills. So here the exchange of gases takes place in the fishes, in the gills. Next, frog. I have written here skin and lungs. Can you tell me why it is so?
Ma'am, may I tell Mahi? Ma'am.
Okay, Mahi. Mahi will tell. Yes, Mahi. Why it
ma'am,
is so?
Ma'am, because the frogs are anaerobic. Ma'am, when they are in the water, ma'am, they will, ma'am, they are breathe with lungs, with the help of lungs. And then, ma'am, when they are on the land, breathe with their moist skin.
No, beta, no. Small bit ma'am, correction is required. Okay, Fiona, tell. Yes, Fiona. Yes, speak out, Peter.
Yes, sir. The athlete has.
Okay,
the athlete has to run fast during the race. The body needs more energy, which increases the demand of oxygen to break down food. So, athlete has.
Okay. I just want to the answer of frog. Why? Yes, Vansh Sharma. Why it is so?
Yes,
why
ma'am.
I have written
ma'am,
that
ma'am,
it breathes through skin or lungs? I want the answer of this question of the frog.
Which?
Why frog? I have written skin or lungs. What's the reason? Okay, Nishchay.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, frogs breathe through both their skin and lungs because frog is an amphibian, and when it is in the water, it breathes through its skin like the fish. They have gills, and when it is on land, they breathe from lungs, like the human beings.
Yes, because they are amphibian, they live on the land and water both. So when they are in water, they breathe through the, not from the gills, they breathe through the moist skin. And when they are on the land, they breathe through the lungs like the human beings. Okay. So already we had discussed about the plants, that how different plants breathe. Plants, can you tell me, children, kindly raise hands, which gas plants breathe in during respiration? Kindly raise your hands only. Which gas plants breathe in? Yes, Anya Jain.
Ma'am, yes. The ma'am here is carbon dioxide.
No, no, I am asking which gas plants breathe in during respiration. Lavish? Kavya? Vedika, anyone among you? Yes, Kavya.
Ma'am, carbon dioxide.
No, children.
Ma'am, can I tell?
May I tell
Ma'am, oxygen.
Because
of
the aerobic
respiration.
Okay,
children, let's be.
Yes, aerobic respiration and oxygen. Children, I think still there is a confusion that plants take in oxygen during the process of respiration, and plants uses carbon dioxide for the process of photosynthesis.
So these processes
are totally different from one another, beta. So just mind it, like us, plants also take in oxygen for the respiration. Am I clear? And for photosynthesis, yes. they use carbon dioxide because they have to prepare food for it. So, okay, children, with this, your chapter is over. Now let's discuss a back exercise. Kindly raise your hand, only those who know the answer. Number one, why does an athlete breathe faster and deeper than usual after finishing the race? Even you people, when you run, you have to take a deep breath of it. Why it is? You breathe so fast. What's the reason behind it? Okay, Bhumi Chaudhary, you want to give the answer?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, athletes need a lot of energy during the race, and for the release of energy, they need a lot of oxygen. Hence, they breathe faster than usual after finishing the race.
Okay. Anybody else? Zikra, same answer. Very good, beta. Very good. Zikra, give the same answer. Same question is there.
Ma'am, can I tell?
Zikra will give the answer.
Okay, ma'am. Ma'am, question number 2 or 1?
No, 1. Same question.
Okay, ma'am. Ma'am, during the run, the demand of energy is high, but the supply of oxygen to produce energy is limited. Therefore, anaerobic respiration takes place in the muscle cells to fulfill the demand of energy after finishing the race, and athlete breathe faster and deeper than usual so that more oxygen supplied to the cell.
Okay, beta. So that means that we breathe faster, or athlete breathe faster after finishing a race, because the demand of oxygen is more at that time. So that's the answer. And the muscles breathe anaerobically. Question number 2. Differences between the aerobic and anaerobic respiration. So children, already when we have done misunderstood words, we have done this question already. So you have to write down both similarities as well as differences between these two. Next, question number 3. Why do we often sneeze? When we inhale, a lot of dust laden air.
Mom, can I tell this answer?
Okay, Anya. Children, okay, raise children can also raise hand.
Mom, may I tell Mahi?
Wait,
ma'am. Okay, ma'am. When we inhale dust particles, pollens, etc., the particles get trapped in the air present in our nasal cavity. However, sometimes these particles may pass the air in the nasal cavity, where they irritate the lining of the cavity, as a result of which we sneeze. Sneezing expels these foreign particles from the inhaled air.
Yes, means sneezing. During sneezing, we expel the foreign particles out of it.
Yes.
So, Mahi, tell the, Anya, I think everybody has understood this answer. And you may find it out also. Number four, question number four. Take three test tubes. Take three test tubes. Fill each of the test tube with the water. Label them A, B, and C. Keep a snail in test tube A, a water plant in test tube B, and in C, keep small and plants too. Snail and plants both are kept in C. Which test tube will have the highest concentration of carbon dioxide? Kindly raise your hands only. I hope the question is clear. In test tube A, we have kept a snail, in B, water plant, and in C, we have kept both. So, what can be the answer for this question?
Mom, A.
Beta, you have to give the reason also why it is so.
Mom, A test tube.
You have to answer.
Mom, tell Mahi.
Mom, by respiration of snail.
Okay, wait. Mahi, let her give the reason.
Mom, the A has the highest concentration of CO2, ma'am, because in the A test tube, only the snail is kept, and ma'am, the respiration of snail, because of the respiration of
snail. Okay, so simply you can say because the respiration of A, because due to the respiration of A, snail, there will be a much more carbon dioxide. Okay. Let's take the right answer. In cockroaches, air enters to the body through the
spiracles.
We get cramps in the muscles.
Lactic acid.
Normal breathing rate.
Mom, 15 to 18.
Next is
Move downwards.
Next, match the following. Yeast with
alcohol.
Diaphragm.
Chest cavity.
Skin.
Chest cavity.
Earthworm.
Fish with gills.
Them leaves. Yes.
So question number 8 is.
It is Mom found. Mom, it is in the last second column. Second last column.
Structural. Skeleton structure.
Mom, ribs.
Ribs.
Mom, ribs.
Mom, diaphragm.
Small lungs. Openings on the sides of insect spiracles. Okay, human organs of respiration.
Lungs and then nostrils.
and nostrils.
Anaerobic organism.
And anaerobic. Yeast.
And last
is next is ant.
So children, this was your chapter.